episode 3 starts off with Daniel and Chosen at the Country Club, pretty much rips some folks off for some money. Terry Silver comes up in there, he tells him to quit playing with him, get the message he got from him.
You're playing with fire, Danny boy. And I am gasoline. Boom.
So then we got Miguel, he's back at home with his mother and his grandmother. He's making breakfast for him to say that he was sorry for running off. His mother apologized for, like, never telling him the true story about his father. But then, you know, Miguel said he understands, but I don't really know if he understands because he has no idea who his father really is. Then he seen that little snippet of him, and then the guy Hector didn't even know that was his child. Then moving right along, we see Sam and her brother talking. So Sam, little brother's asked for advice because he's getting bullied by the guy from Cobra Kai who he once was bullying, and he kind of salty about that. So he ain't understand. He asked Sam for help, and then she pretty much like dissed him, like, hey, keep moving. Cause Sam is still out here questioning her life after taking that L to Tori in the championship last year. Then we see Daniel and Chosen. They still trying to take down Terry Silver and Cobra Kai. They trying to figure out like who he know that they could get on side with. Then Daniel comes up with this idea right here.
Mr. Silver, you just bought yourself a champion.
You suck, LaRusso! I know! There's nothing you've got that I can't counter. Your karate's a joke.
Mike fucking Barnes.
Then Miguel, he's hanging with his friends. He's over there getting advice on pretty much how to get Sam back. Like, this guy, Miguel, pretty much is simping by nature. And his friends is giving him horrible advice. They're going to tell him to text her this. And then you're going to see how Sam play him. But my thing is, Miguel, like, just keep it moving, bro. Like, stop playing around. You're wasting your time. Wasting your time. Then back at Miguel's house, his mother pretty much is telling Johnny that she's pregnant. Johnny asked that, hey, we use protection. She said, hey, it don't always work. I suggest Johnny to make sure that he gets a DNA test. Like, it ain't nothing, you know what I'm saying? If you're using protection and she ended up pregnant, Johnny, get a DNA test, bro. Stop playing. Stop playing out here. Then we back with Sam, show that with her homegirl, showing pretty much like the text message that Miguel is showing, like just showing like, hey man, look at this lame, he keep texting me this. Her homegirl is giving her advice on pretty much how to play Miguel. Yeah, it's getting crazy. Moving right along, we see Daniel and Chosen pretty much stalking Mike Barnes. They pretty much outside of his house. He comes out of his house, it looks like he's posing for the camera for a minute, but they getting out of control. So Johnny and Miguel's mom go to the grocery store to get a pregnancy test. And then you got Johnny, he's still confused, like he don't know how he gonna be a parent even though he has a teenage son. He need to be questioned like, hey, how did you really get pregnant and we used all that protection? That's what he need to be doing. You know what I'm saying? He acting real slow right now. Then we back with Miguel and his sucker friends, and they giving him some bad advice. They telling him to buy Sam a necklace so she like pretty much forgive him. But I don't see why he was asking for forgiveness and he was looking for his dad. Is it because she lost her match? Like, I don't get this. Like, he's so worried about her and she ain't nowhere thinking about him at all. Then we see Sam, she hang with her friends getting pampered. Then moving right along, we see that Danny, he's still salty, still stalking folks, as you can see. And then my dude Johnny over here trying to learn how to be a dad, even though he do got a teenage son. And then we got Sam, she over here acting like she over. Hey, we got Sam acting like she L 11 from Stranger Things. So while sitting in the tank, Sam does find out that the problem is her and not nobody else, so she ends up fighting herself. So the battle is within herself, within Sam. So while Daniel and Mike Barnes was having a good conversation, Charles and Miss Reed what was going on, he comes in there and attacks Mike Barnes, but then after that situation happened, they do all get on the same page and want to take down Terry Silver. So Miguel, you know, he's still so caught up in Sam that he's looking for ways to talk to her. So he goes over to Johnny's house and asks him for advice. And Johnny tells him to be honest with her, be honest with Sam. But to be honest with you, he should have told him, hey, keep her pushing, son. Like, you're a martial arts champion. Quit playing out here. But then, you know, you can't really expect that advice from Johnny because he is lightweight, kind of being suckered into, like, this whole pregnancy situation when he said, hey, he been using protection. But then he just going along with the flow. So I don't know what Johnny on for real. I don't know what type of advice to really expect from him in regards to that situation. Then we got Mike Barnes, Daniel Chosen. They still talking about how they going to take down Silver. They really obsessed with dude. So we still got Miguel. He's still simple by nature over Sam. But listen to this conversation.
I need that time too. I need a little break to figure out who I am outside of all that.
When you say break, what do you mean?
So at this point, Sam just confused, like, hey, why is he still standing here? You know what I'm saying? She tried to give it to him easily, like, hey, I just need some space. But, you know, he just kept forcing the issue, just like, you know, out of the SIP Symbology handbook. But, hey, just take a listen to the conversation. Just listen.
I'm not okay right now. And I don't think I will be until I figure this out for myself. But it doesn't mean that we can't still be friends.
Then she gonna put him in the friend zone. And then, you know, at that point, Miguel should have just been like, all right, cool. He should have walked away. Don't accept that. But hey, listen what else happens.
It doesn't mean that we can't be friends, right?
Promise. Of course.
See, yeah, by the look on Sam's face, she looking like, how can I get rid of him? Like, she thought the friend zone thing was gonna do it. You feel me? He accepted it. He was going along with it, but it is more to come. Just look.
Come whenever, okay?
Yeah.
Miguel talking about Kyle anytime she just put him in the friend zone. Hey, my advice I would give, hey, when that phone call happened, that phone better be on speaker. She better be hearing some thunderclaps. You hear me? Or you yourself having a good time, bro. Quit going out like a simp. Then my guy Miguel, you know what I'm saying, he has a breakdown right in her backyard. But do anybody notice Sam around? Like, Sam was standing behind him. You see, as soon as he was having his breakdown, she left. Now I'm saying, Miguel, focus on yourself, man. Better yourself. You was a world champion. So Johnny's pretty much telling Miguel's mama that he's ready to be a father again. He's ready. Then Mike Barnes comes to his furniture store. He notices that it's on fire. Pretty much it was a message sent by Terry Silver, like, hey, quit playing with me. Y'all been playing a little bit too much. Yeah, he ain't playing. And then Terry Silver pays Daniel a visit in the sauna, like, hey, bro, okay, let the games begin. Episode 4 starts off with Miguel's mom pretty much having a montage of how life would be with Johnny in the future. So Daniel and Chosen, they still obsessed with Terry, and they pretty much discussing the plan on how they're gonna take Terry Silver down before he goes to a charity event. And then Johnny speaking with his baby mama, saying that he have another town, that he needs a job. And then you got Sam, she's over there doing herself, you know what I'm saying? She's free now, she's over there having a good time at the pool. And then Miguel just constantly keep coming around her, you know what I'm saying? He just wanna have some attention. And then look, she's just very annoyed with Miguel, like, hey bro, what you wanna do? You wanna have a seat or what? What's going on? And then we got this guy, he's still bullying Sam's little brother. He ain't playing no games with him. Then we see Tori and Robbie. This is their first time seeing each other since Robbie been back from Mexico. You know, he's trying to tell her, like, hey, you know, kind of stay away from Cobra Kai. She's telling her, hey, bro, don't tell me what to do. So I said, hey, I'm going to let you figure it out on your own. Then you find out that Terry Silver's at the charity event that Daniel, his wife, is at. So Daniel kind of on 10. So Cobra Kai continues to bully Sam's little brother and Daniel's son. That continues to happen. A former student of Johnny comes to his house so he can fix his phone so he can have a job. Then we back at Miguel. Instead of enjoying his time at the beach, he over there being thirsty.
You better get to the park and find the abandoned bus.
Oh, I think you're thinking of Into the Wild.
That's the one, yeah. Look, I was thinking of Brave in the Lazy River if you want to join.
Right after this chapter, I just really
want to
see what happens to the bus driver.
Of course, yeah.
Yeah, so Miguel's doing too much. He's been having a good time, but he's sitting over there watching Sam read chapters. And then he moves along to Cobra Kai, beefing with everybody else and for the pool, and what spot is the pool. Then over at the banquet, Terry Silver talking to Daniel's wife. And so then we find out that Johnny, he gets a job, so pretty much doing Uber service. And we got, you know, Miguel still over there hanging around, just waiting, just being lame for real. And then Cobra Kai, they start beefing up again. So he see Robbie over there, so Miguel want to get tough. And then they say they're going to do a swimming challenge between Tori and Hulk. Back at the charity event, Terry Silver trolls Danny by buying his plant at the auction. And then you see Johnny, he's complaining about his job because he's been eating everybody's food and being late on the pickups. And then so Robbie tried to talk to the young kid. He didn't want to listen to him, like going somewhere. So Tori and Hawk, they had a swim challenge, and then Hawk loses, but then he says that Tori cheated because it was a hole in his float. And then back over at the banquet, we got Daniel being creepy. He over there looking at Terry Silver, talk to the director, and pretty much he embarrassed his wife by acting a fool. And then Terry Silver said, like, I ain't said that about your wife. Then we back at Robbie and Tori. He tried to give some guidance, Shane wanna listen. He just walked away, something that Miguel should do. And then, you know, Miguel runs up against Robbie again, wanna fight. Then Johnny pulls up, and they all walk away. And then this is the end of the episode. And then the episode ends with Danny's wife talking to him like he wanted the kids.
You had a fight at a furniture store? Enough is enough. Daniel, this ends now. You really won't stop.
You need to let me and Chosen handle this. It's the only way to make it all end.
Fine. Handle it. I won't be here. Away from here. Away from you. I just need space. Taking the kids with you.
Thank y'all for watching as I recapped episodes 3 and 4 of Cobra Kai Season 5. Make sure you guys check out the show. It's a real good show. And please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel.